Yeah, good morning everybody. Yeah, shall we start? Only 14 members are there. Pavani? Or Ravi?
Yes.
Okay, we will see some problems today. Can you able to see this one note?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Do I need to discuss the earlier problems also, or shall I go to next problems? So I am using now tab, graphic tab. So it is easy to me to explain. Okay. From the first problem itself, I am coming. So here, if you can see this problem, calculate the mole mass concentration of 2 gram moles of sulfur dioxide to be used to manufacture sulfuric acid in a 0.2 meter cube of reactor. So if you can see here, what is the data given? Moles, N is equal to 2 gram moles. 2 moles data has been given, and volume of reactor is given as 0.2 meter cube. So we have to determine what we have to determine. This one, calculate the mass concentration. Mass concentration is nothing but gram per liter or gram per meter cube. So okay, we have to determine mass concentration, which is denoted by this one, in gram per liter or gram per meter cube. So to determine, in order to do so, first we have to do, we know that moles is nothing but weight by molecular weight, is nothing but moles. So here in this formula, we are provided with moles. At the same time, the component is given, sulfur dioxide. Okay, sulfur dioxide is given. So molecular weight of sulfur dioxide, we already know what is the molecular weight. Then we have to determine what is the weight of the sulfur dioxide. So weight is nothing but moles into molecular weight. So moles is given as 2 gram moles into molecular weight. So I am writing with units, 2 gram moles into molecular weight of that SO2 is 64 gram per gram mole. So if you can see here, gram mole will be cancelled out. 2 into 64, it will be 640 grams. So we are provided with volume. So density, mass density or mass concentration is nothing but rho. So it is nothing but weight by volume, or we can simply say this is density. Okay, weight is 640 grams and volume is 0.2 meter cube. So this is 640 by 0.2 meter cube. Oh no, 64 into 2 is 128. Yeah, this is 128. This is 128. This is 128 divided by 0.2 is 640 gram per meter cube. Okay, meanwhile you can calculate with your calcis. Okay, I don't have a calci here available, scientific calculator, so you can calculate. Hope you understood this one. This is simply from your CPP course. For the practice itself, I have kept here this problem. And next we will move to the next problem, which is the second problem, a mixture of noble gases. See here, helium, argon, krypton and xenon are there. The three gases is contained as a mixture and is at a total pressure. So this is total pressure. So we will write the data here. So for problem 2, I am writing data, given data. So the noble gases, we already know, helium, argon, krypton and xenon. Then the total pressure is given as 100 kilopascal. So total pressure we used to denote with PT. PT is equal to 100 kilopascal. And a temperature, here if you can see, this is the temperature. So temperature is given as T is equal to 200 degree Kelvin. So if the mixture has equal kilomole fraction, okay, equal kilomole fraction, in terms of kilomole fractions, we have to take the moles, total moles in kilomoles. they are indicating that one. If a mixture has equal more kilomole fraction of each of the gases determined, first one is the composition of the mixture in terms of mole fraction. Okay, composition can be expressed as mass concentration, mole concentration. Then also in the fractions like mole fraction, mass fractions, we can express the composition. The composition they are asking to express in mole fraction. Then total molar concentration. What is total molar concentrations? Nothing but capital C. Then mass density, rho. We have to calculate rho here. We have to calculate mass fractions. We are denoting with x. So x or for the gases, or we can denote with y. So x or y for the individual species, individual gases, we have to determine. So now we have to assume what is the basis. So this is the data, overall data they have provided. So basis is from this treatment, if the mixture has equal kilomole fraction. So basis is very much important here. Why? If you take a basis as 1 kilomole, then every composition 1 kilomole of mixture, basis of mixture of gas, mixture of gas is present, then the composition will be, see what will happen, the moles are of each gas, so equimolar, they are telling this is equal molar, equal kilomole fraction means equimolar they are present. So here we can assume for each gas it will have 0.25 kilomole. When we take a basis as 100 kilomole, 100 kilomole of gas mixture, then we can take the moles of each gas is equal to 25 kilomole. So basis is very important. So this is nothing but 1 kilomole of mixture composition. In every kilomole, 0.25 kilomole will be noble gases like helium, 0.25 kilomole, then argon also 0.25 kilomole, because here it is given equal kilomole fractions. So because of that, every gas molecule will have a 0.25 kilomole, 0.25 kilomole. If you take a basis as 100 kilomole, we will have a 25 kilomole of helium, 25 kilomole of xenon, 25 kilomole of argon, and 24 kilomole of krypton because of this statement. So we have to note this statement. This statement is very much important in order to determine the compositions. So now what, so if you take a basis 1 kilomole, it is already here, we solved for 100 kilomole. Let us solve for 1 kilomole. So here if you say, so total mass of a mixture, total mass of a mixture. So total mass will be, mass is nothing but moles is nothing but moles is equal to weight by molecular weight. Then mass or weight, weight is nothing but moles into molecular weight. So individual moles. So individual moles for the first helium composition, the moles will be 0.25 and the molecular weight of helium is 4, plus next one is argon will have a moles of, because it is equimolar, 0.25 into some its molecular weight, plus next one argon and krypton is also moles with 0.25 into its molecular weight is 83.8, plus for the xenon, moles are 0.25 into its molecular weight 131.3. So when we just total out all these one, okay, I don't have a calci, but it will come around 64.77 kg, it will come, okay, 64.77. So if you calculate a individual mass fraction is nothing but individual moles by total moles. Our weight fraction is nothing but individual weight by total weight. So mass mole fraction of, or we can simply indicate, because these are gases, we are taking a notation Y for the gases. So mole fraction of helium gas is nothing but individual moles. Individual moles of helium present is 0.24. This is nothing but quantity n. Okay, n into molecular weight. Okay, this is also same thing, moles into molecular weight. So they are asked to determine the mass fractions. So this is mass fractions. Why helium is equal to mass fraction? So this is individual weight. So n into mw is nothing but weight. Weight is equal to moles into molecular weight. So individual moles, then total moles will be this quantity. This is a total. So 64.77 will be total. 647.7 it will come, or 64.77 it will come. We have to just verify. So when we calculate this, the mole fractions will come around this one only. Okay, same thing for the argon. We have to use this as a weight. For the krypton, we have to use this 0.25 and this 83.8 as a individual weight divided by this total weight. For every composition, we can calculate what is the mass fractions. So similarly, when they ask about mole fractions, so mole fractions, then we want a average molecular weight. Then average molecular weight can be calculated as, see here, average molecular weight can be calculated as MW average is nothing but total mass. Okay, total mass divided by whatever the basis we are taking, that one. So here the total mass for the 1 kilomole fraction is, it will come around 64.775. It is right only. 64.775 divided by our basis is 1 kilomole we are taking. So 1 kilomole is nothing but 64.775. So kg per kg mole. So this is molecular weight, average molecular weight for a total mixture is 64.775. Okay, because here it is total, in this problem, already solved problem, the basis is 100 kilomole. Whereas when we are solving in a new method, which is basis is 1 kilomole, so here we are using 1 kilomole basis. So that's why the answers are same, but only the basis will change. Here for this basis, every quantity will contain 0.25 mole. Whereas for 1 kilomole, 100 kilomole basis, every quantity will contain 25 kilomole of fraction, 25 kilomoles of each gas composition. So for the part B is they are asking to calculate the total composition or a total concentration, C. So here if you can see, they already given T is equal to 200 Kelvin, PT is equal to 100 Kelvin, and R is equal to, we have to derive this one, R. So already in the last class, I have said how to derive R values. So let's see once again how to derive the R values. We already know what is the STP conditions. Okay, STP condition is nothing but standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature and pressure conditions. So one more condition is there, NTP condition, which is normal temperature and pressure conditions. Okay, standard temperature and pressure conditions and normal temperature and pressure conditions. What is the standard temperature and pressure conditions? See, standard temperature and pressure conditions are nothing but standard temperature is in which the standard condition temperature is 0 degree centigrade, and standard pressure is nothing but 1 atmosphere. Okay, then what is NTP, normal temperature and pressure conditions? This is nothing but normal room temperature 25 degree centigrade, and pressure is same as 1 atmosphere. So these are the conditions. What these conditions are saying to us? Okay, these conditions are now what these conditions are saying to us. So at STP, every gas molecules at one atma will occupy 22.414 liters of volume. This HCP conditions is saying, irrespective of the type of gas, okay, at one atma, at standard temperature and pressure conditions, every gas molecule will occupy this many volumes, 22.414 liters volume inside any pressure, any vessel. So it is saying that one. So at these conditions, we have to calculate the R value. Okay, from the ideal gas law, we know PV is equal to nRT. Okay, and 1 gram mole of any gas will occupy 22.414 liters at one standard atma. So here we already know what is P. P is 1 atma. This one, so 1 atma, and this 1 atmosphere gas at 1 mole, 1 gram mole will occupy 22.414 liters. So volume is 22.414 liters. Then is equal to this moles is 1 gram mole. That 1 gram mole of gas will occupy 22.414 liters into R is there. We have to determine that R, and STP conditions in standard temperature and pressure conditions. What is T? T is nothing but 0 degree centigrade. 0 degree centigrade, we already know it is nothing but plus 273. So it is Kelvin. So R value is equal to 1 atma into 22.414. This is in liters, divided by 1 gram mole into 273 degree Kelvin. So it will come around 0.08206 atma liter per gram mole degree Kelvin. So this is the basic R value. From this basic R value, according to our problem, whatever the units are given, we have to just convert this basic R value into the respective R values. So how to convert that? Let's see how to convert that one. Maximum our in our every problem, they used to give in SI units. So SI units is for the pressure, instead of atma, we have to put in a Pascal. For the liters, this is volume. For the volume, in the SI units is meter cube. Then the gram moles or kilo moles, it can be used interchangeably. And SI units for the temperature is also Kelvin. So we have to convert this atma to Pascals and this liter to meter cube. So 1 atma is equal to, we have to know this formula before solving any problems. We have to know this conversion value. 1 atma is equal to, we already know that it is nothing but 760 mmHg. At the same time, 1 atma is equal to 101325 Pascals. Okay, this is the conversion formula. And then 1 liter is equal to 10 power minus 3 meter cube. So these three conversions formula we needs to be in handy. Otherwise we can't easily determine the values. Otherwise we have to remember the various R values. Around 11 to 12 R values will be there. We have to just by heart that one. So instead of doing that one, we are just deriving the R value, basic R value, and then we can easily convert that values. So if you see, R is equal to 0.08206, or simply we can say it is 0.0821 atma liter per mole or gram mole degree Kelvin. Remember, in every problem, when they are giving mole means it is gram mole only. When they are specifically mentioning that this is kilo mole, then they have to mention with K. Okay, they for the gram mole, they need not to mention with gram mole. Okay, mole is also gram mole. We can take by terminology. So this is 0.0821. So we need to convert this atma to Pascal. So to convert that one, 1 atma is equal to 101325 Pascal, we already know that. So this 0.0821 to convert into Pascal, we have to multiply with 101325. Then we will obtain this atma instead of, we will obtain Pascal instead of this atma. So in order to convert this liter to meter cube, we are having this conversion formula. 1 liter is equal to 10 power minus 3 meter cube. So into 10 power minus 3 meter cube. So whole quantity, this whole quantity when multiplied, we will obtain 8.314. So we already converted our units to ATMA to Pascal. So liters to meter cube, Pascal meter cube per mole degree Kelvin. So this is the another value. So depending on the particular units, we can calculate. So here if you see Pascal, okay, Pascal is the unit for pressure. So Pascal is equal to Newton per meter square. So you need to also remember this one. Newton into meter is equal to joule. Okay, these are the electrical conversion formulas from the electrical to some chemical energy. So chemically the heat quantity is denoted by joule. Okay, for the joule in terms of pressures, we can just denote with Newton into meter is nothing but joule. So these two also you have to remember. So from this one, if you see Pascal is nothing but Newton per meter square into meter cube is already there, into meter cube divided by mole into Kelvin. So meter cube and this meter square will be cancelled, only 1 meter will be left. So Newton into meter divided by mole into Kelvin. So this Newton meter is nothing but joule. So this R value is also applicable in terms of energy quantities, which is 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. So same R value which is given for the pressure in Pascal meter cube per mole Kelvin is also applicable in terms of heat quantity, 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. So this is this 8.3. Hello
sir.
Yeah, now it is okay. Call on hold, it is coming sir. For me. Yeah, can you say whatever I'm drawing in OneNote, it is coming now
sir.
Okay, yeah. Okay, this formula, if you see, this is in joule per mole Kelvin, which is in heat quantities. This is used in your heat transfer course. Whereas this is in Pascals, which is pressure terms, we will use because of our driving force mass transfer, which is due to pressure difference or something. So we will use this 8.314 in our pressure quantities. Okay, this is used in your heat transfer. So like this, we have to convert the formula, this basic formula, which is 0.08212 to this 8.314. So these formulas we will apply in our mass transfer problems. So if you see in the top one from the same problem, so now here it is, we have to calculate what is the composition or a total concentration of a mixture. So we already know from ideal gas law what is C is equal to P by RT. We already know that. So this, since this is the total composition, this is a total pressure, PT we can take. This as PT. This is also PT as per our terminology. So you already know how we obtained this 8.314 Pascal meter cube per mole degree Kelvin was there. So for converting this kilo, I will show this one also. Will not catch this problems. So here if you see from this one, I'm writing once again here, R is equal to 8.314 Pascal meter cube per mole degree Kelvin. So we need to convert this Pascal to kilopascal and we need to convert this mole to kilomole. So same we will obtain this. See, 8.314. So Pascal to kilopascal is, we have to multiply with 1000. into 1000. So for mole to kilomole, we have to just multiply with 10 power minus 3. This is 10 power minus 3. This is also 10 power minus 3. We have to divide this. So 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 3. Then we will obtain kilopascal meter cube per kilomole degree Kelvin. This 10 power minus 3, this 10 power minus 3 will be cancelled out, and the left out terms will be this one. 8.314 kilopascal meter cube per kilomole degree Kelvin. Or otherwise, same quantity, same value, 8.314 pascal meter cube per mole Kelvin. Okay, you have to just note this one. This two. So same thing was given there. Okay, yeah. From this, see PT by RT. C is equal to PT by RT from the ideal gas law. So PT already given, this one. So 100 kilopascal. So 100 kilopascal we are getting. So then we already defined as per our given units. Our R value we already defined 8.314 kilopascal meter cube per kilomole degree Kelvin. So this one, so 200 degree Kelvin. Instead of, in place of T, we are substituting 200 Kelvin. This 200 Kelvin. Kelvin, this Kelvin and this Kelvin will be cancelled out. This kilopascal and this kilopascal will be cancelled out, and the left out terms is meter cube per kilomole. So this will go to the upside. So since it's the bottom denominator, so kilomole per meter cube will be left. So this is 0.6014 kilomole per meter cube are the units. So here clearly I have shown you how the units can be cancelled out. So this is the final answer. Then the last one is mass density or the mass concentration they want to calculate us. So this is total mass density they have asked. So we have to use total concentration C. So C into then for the total composition we have to use average molecular weight. We already determined what is average molecular weight here also. So the same thing we have to just substitute this total concentration into average molecular weight. Concentration units will be kilomole per meter cube, and the average molecular weight will have a units of kg per kg mole. So this kilomole kilomole will be cancelled, so kg per meter cube will be left out. This is nothing but mass concentration, or simply we can say density, kg per meter. So this is the problem 2. If you have any doubt, you can stop me anywhere and just ask me. Okay, this problem is also completed. Let's explain once again. So if you see here problem 3, so 1 kilomole, this is given as 1 kilomole of a gas mixture. Let's see, this is 1 kilomole of a gas mixture. So gas mixture is total mixture composition is 1 kilomole at a total pressure, this is PT. So I am writing here in the different color so that it will be easy. So problem 3 I am writing, problem 3 given data. So in every problem you have to write first, in the exam also, what is given data first, write down, then it will be easy for you. So from this PT is nothing but, so 1 kilomole is the total moles. Total moles we can denote by NT. So 1 kilomole is the total gas composition, and total pressure they are giving, PT is equal to 250 kilopascal, and temperature is 303 degree Kelvin. Okay, capital T is equal to 303 degree Kelvin. Okay, contains 1 kilomole of gas mixture at a total pressure of 250 kilopascal and 303 degree Kelvin contains, this is 10 percentage CH4. Out of this 1 kilomole, 10 percentage is CH4, and out of this 1 kilomole, 30 percentage is C2H6, and out of this 1 kilomole, 60 percentage is H2 by volume. So this is important. By volume or by mole, we can say by pressure is same, because for the gases, volume percentage is equal to pressure percentage is equal to mole percentage. So we can take this 10%, 30% and 60% as the molar composition also, because it is given as in terms of volume. So because it is given as 10% and 30% and 60% as volume, so we can say percentage divided by 100 is nothing but fraction. So mole percentage, volume percentage is given, so we can take directly from this formula it is as a mole percentage. Then we will say since these are gases, we can denote with Y. So CH4, so the first one is 10% is nothing but 0.1 mole fraction of CH4 is there. Then the second composition is C2H6, which is 30%. This is percentage, is equal to 0.3. Percentage divided by 100 is equal to fractions. So YH2 is equal to, it is also present in 60%, is nothing but 0.6. So we have to decode the data like this. Then the absolute velocities of each species are this one. The absolute velocities are nothing but respectively. It is given here, the respectively, meaning they are referring, still they are referring according to the statement, they are referring to this composition CH4, this component CH4, C2H6 and H2. So this is minus 10 meters per second is applicable for CH4, whereas this C2H6, this minus 5 meters per second is applicable for the C2H6, whereas this plus 15 meters per second is applicable for H2, because here it is given respectively. So still they are referring to these components only. So according to the problem, the velocities UCH4 is equal to minus 10 meters per second, and at the same time the velocity of C2H6 gas is minus 5 meters per second, and at the same time the velocity of hydrogen H2 is plus 15 meters per second. These are the velocities and their respective compositions are already given. So now we have to determine all in the z direction, only one direction. So this compresses, they are asking to consider only in the one dimensional or one direction axis. We do not worry about remaining two directions or two axes. Okay, so determine the molar average velocity, u mole, for the mixture. So we already defined what is our u mole. U mole is nothing but sigma ci into ui divided by sigma ci. Yeah, it's written here, you can see. So this one. So next one is evaluate fluxes. Okay, four fluxes. It is accidentally given, I guess, not four. Evaluate fluxes JCH4 mole, NCH4 mole. So from the relationship between these two fluxes, we can obtain. We will see that one first. Okay, we already have what are the values. So here if you see, this U mole, according to the definition, is nothing but sigma I is equal to 1 to N species into Ci into Ui divided by Ci. When we decode this one, if you see this one, U mole is equal to sigma, I'm not writing I is equal to 1 to N. So simply I am writing without any notation, because already here we have already written I is equal to 1 to n. Just simply for the solution purpose I am writing here. Please note that. So divided by sigma ci. So if you see, this is sigma means summation for n number of species. So yeah, if you see, the meaning of this summation is summation of I is equal to 1 to n for first species to up to the nth species is nothing but the summation. The meaning of this summation is from the first species, number one species to up to n species, n number of species contained in the particular mixture. So if you decode this one, let's see. So this one, if you see, sigma ci into ui is there. So this Ci divided by this is total concentration for n number of species. So this is nothing but Ct, or simply we are denoting with C. So this Ci individual by total is nothing but, since these are in gases, so Yi we can take. So this is nothing but Yi into Ui. So summation for n number of species, sigma I is equal to 1 to n, Yi into Ui. So this is the meaning of this one. So now we already have what is U mole. U mole in terms of mole fraction is sigma I is equal to 1 to n, Yi into Ui. So when we decode this one for our gases composition, so U mole is nothing but implies U mole is equal to, the first species is YCH4 into UCH4 plus YC2H6 into UC2H6 plus only three species are there. So YH2 into UH2. So we will substitute what is this YCH4. YCH4 is this one, 0.1, 10%. This is 0.1 into UCH4 is this one, minus 10 meters per second plus YC2H6 is nothing but 30%, which is 0.3 in terms of fraction. So 0.3 into UCH4 is this one, minus 5 meters per second, okay, we are taking meters per second, plus YH2 is this one, 0.6 into this one, UH2 is 15, so 0.6 into 15 this one. So when we just evaluate whole term, we'll obtain the sum answer. So U mole is equal to something we will obtain. So I already provided you what is the value for that one also. If you have calci, you can see that one. See here, 6.5% is that. 6.5 meters per second. So molar average velocity is nothing but 6.5 meters per second. If you have a calci, you can verify this or by calculating all these terms. 0.65. Then part B. Part B is what is the total concentration. This is simple. We already know part B is this one. Okay, part B is evaluate the fluxes. Okay, fluxes we want. For the fluxes, we want the individual concentrations. Okay, these are mole fractions. So we want concentrations now. So first of all, we will calculate what are the mixture concentration, total mixture concentration. From we already know from ideal gas law, C is equal to P by RT. How it is? So PV is equal to nRT. So n by v, this v we are sending this side. This RT is sending, this whole RT is sending to the left hand side. So N by V is equal to P by RT. So N by V is nothing but this concentration, because N is in mole and V is in meter cube. So mole per meter cube is the unit for concentration. C is equal to P by RT. So this way we will obtain that C is equal to P by RT. So we already know what is P. Total pressure, they already given 100 kilopascal, something they have given 250 kilopascal. Okay. Yeah, here if you see, PT is equal to 250 kilopascal and temperature is 303 degree Kelvin. From this one, so here if you consider, this is 250 kilopascal divided by 303 Kelvin. So it is in kilopascal, so we have to use our R value in kilopascal. 8.314 kilopascal meter cube per kilomole degree Kelvin. Here kilopascal will be cancelled out. Here Kelvin will be cancelled out. Then the left out term is kilomole per meter cube. So 250 divided by 8.314 into 303. here we can obtain that value. What is the value? So if you have a calcium, you can see. So this one, this value, 90.09924 kilomole per meter cube. Then if you consider, if you convert this kilomole to mole, we have to multiply with 10 cube. 10 cube is nothing but 1000. So into 1000, then 99.24 we can obtain. So my suggestion is just take your calcium out and then use. My calcium is with college only. On my desk, calcium is there. So now if you see the, we have calculated the total concentration of a gas mixture. Then this CCH4. CCH4 is nothing but what is the composition? This is overall CT, total concentration of the gas mixture. So among the total concentration, what is the concentration of CH4 in that one? So we already know the mole fraction of CH4 is 0.1, nothing but 10%. So into 0.1 into this whole concentration is nothing but this is the individual concentration of CH4. When we want for C2H6, we can multiply this 99.24 with 0.3. When we want for H2, we can multiply this 99.24 quantity with 0.6. Okay, for the CH4 they are referring. So we have to calculate the fluxes only for CH4. So NCH4 and JCH4. So that's why we are only calculating for CCH4. Okay, CCH4 we already calculated this one. And then here if you consider, according to the definition of fluxes with respect to some arbitrary coordinate, so this is Ji is equal to Ca into Ui minus U0. Okay, velocity of a species, this is velocity of the observer moving with some velocity. So when we write for the single species CH4, JCH4 is equal to CCH4 into UCH4 minus U mole, this one. Okay, U mole. Okay, we already know what is CCH4, we know 9.924, and UCH4 we already know from the previous from the data, minus 10 meters per second. This one U mole, just we determined this one, 6.5 meters per second. We can calculate this value, mole per meter square second J. Then from the relationship between fluxes, so relationship between fluxes is nothing but Ni is equal to NXi plus Ji. When we write for single component, so NCH4 is equal to N into XCH4 plus JCH4. So this is for this quantity to calculate flux with respect to stationary coordinate. According to this, what is this N? Capital N is nothing but sum of the fluxes. Here N is equal to NCH4 plus NC2H6 plus NH2. So this is the meaning of this overall N. So we already know from the definition of flux, Ni is equal to Ci into Ui. Similarly, for the capital N, which is for total, we can write C into U, or simply we can say U mole we can write. Okay, since this is for overall composition, overall flux for the total composition, this is for individual composite flux for the individual compositions. So if you see this one from the relationship between fluxes, so this one, so this equation, what will happen? NCH4 is equal to, we already know, instead of N we can write this formula, this one we can write C into U mole in place of this X. Okay, X is nothing but individual concentration divided by total concentration. So XCH4, that one. So CCH4 divided by total concentration plus this one JCH4 is left. JCH4. So we can cancel out this C, then the left out terms will be NCH4 is equal to CCH4 into U mole plus JCH4. Okay, that's the same formula. This formula we are applying here. Okay, I hope this understood. From the Xi, how can we obtain this formula? CCH4 into U mole. Okay, is it okay? Then next problem is, okay, we already done in previous class this one, before DAB is equal to DBA, you can watch that video, not wasting time anymore. Okay, then the next one is this problem. Yeah, you can see this problem is, yeah, this problem is here, problem number 4, I guess this one. So problem number 4, so here if you see, calculate the amount of oxygen diffused in 1 hour under steady state conditions through a non diffusing gas mixture of methane and hydrogen in a volume ratio of 2:1. So here also it is very important, see, amount of oxygen. So calculate the amount of oxygen means whether it may be kilomole per mole per second or kg per second. So amount means, then diffused in a 1 hour. So 1 hour time they already given. So under steady state conditions through a non-diffusing gas mixture. So non-diffusing gas means A through non-diffusing P. Then we can assume that whatever the first gas is there, it is A, and the next two gases are, these are, methane is B and hydrogen is C, we can consider. Okay, by seeing this, we can consider the first whatever the gas comes will be A according to our notation scheme, then it will be easy. Otherwise, without any notations also we can do. But every formula is written in terms of notation, NA, NB, NC, XA, UI, CA. So because of that, we have to write A, B, denote with A, B, C. So we are writing it. So steady state they already given. So every formula here in the mass transfer is applicable for steady state case according to your syllabus. So A through non-diffusing B case. So A is diffusing, but in the stagnant layer or a non-diffusing gas mixture. So this is the case of A through non-diffusing B. So problem 3, given data, writing. So this is the case of A through non-diffusing B. A through non-diffusing B. Okay, A through non-diffusing B. Then next one is given as methane and B. So A we can take as, A is oxygen, B is methane, C is hydrogen. So we can denote in that way. Then the volume ratio, or nothing but mole ratio, we can take directly. Mole ratio of this methane and hydrogen is equal to 2:1. Then total moles are is equal to 2 + 1 is equal to 3. Then total moles of this non-diffusing gas mixture is 2 + 1 is equal to 3. Then mole fraction of methane. So Y methane CH4 is equal to individual moles by total moles. Individual moles of methane is 2 divided by 3. This is mole fraction of methane. And YH2, mole fraction of H2 is 1 divided by 3. So like this way, we have to formulate the basis for our composition analysis. Then what they are asking is the diffusivities of are estimated to be this one. So diffusivities. So methane we are considering, oxygen we are considering as A, and hydrogen we are considering C. So this is DAC, then oxygen is A and this is methane B. So this is given as DAB. The total pressure is PT. Total pressure is 1 × 10⁵ न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वेयर, और सिंपली वी कैन से इट इज पास्केल. सो 1 × 10⁵ न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वेयर इज टोटल प्रेशर. देन द टेम्परेचर इज गिवन एज 0 °C. सो टेम्परेचर इज 0 °C, और नथिंग बट वी कैन राइट इन द एसए यूनिट्स 273 °K. द पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एट टू प्लेन्स. सो इफ यू कंसिडर दिस एज ए डिफ्यूजन पाथ, so here it is a mixture of CH4 plus H2, and in that one what is diffusing? Oxygen is diffusing. This O2 is getting diffused in that one. So at one part, so we're starting of the point, okay, whatever the first one given, so mass transfer will take place from higher concentration region to lower concentration region, or higher pressure to lower pressure. So whatever the initial pressure, initial value they are given, the first value you can take as first pressure value, 13,000. Then after reaching here, the partial pressure at of O2 at plane 2, this is a diffusion part, nothing but Z. When we consider this as Z1 and this as Z2, it is Z1 minus Z2. So this is 6,500 Newton per meter square. So now if you see what we have to calculate, so they are asking us to calculate flux. Okay, for calculation of flux, since these two compositions CH4 and H2 are present as a mixture, so one DAB value they have not given. So DAB and DAC they have given. So in order to estimate the composition diffusivities, the formula applicable is, okay, you can neglect this one, okay, this is irrelevant for you, there is a huge derivation for this one, this one you can consider, you can remember this one, okay, you don't consider this one. So DAM is equal to, DAM is nothing but diffusivity of a mixture, that one DAB. So DAB, DAM for the mixture is given as 1 by YI by DAI sigma I is equal to B to some species, N number of species, whatever the species are. So we can expand this one, 1 by YI, the first composition is CH4, 1 by YCH4 divided by 1 by DO2 into CH4, we can say. CH4 we are denoting with C, I guess, B, yeah, B we are denoting, this is CH4, since we are using YCH4 here, we have to use here CH4 plus YH2 divided by DO2H2. So in our notation scheme, we can apply this one, so is equal to 1 by YCH4 divided by DAB plus 1 by YH2 divided by DAC. So we already know 1 by YCH4. We already defined here YCH4 is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 divided by 2 by 3, 1 by 2 by 3 divided by DAC, DAB, they have already given, DAB is equal to 1.86, I am writing clearly here, is equal to 1 by 2 by 3 divided by 1.86 into 10 power minus 5, plus the next composition is for hydrogen, 1 by 1 by 3 divided by 6.99 into 10 power minus 5. So after calculating, you can obtain this value, meters per second. So this formula is wrong. So instead of, in place of this formula, you have to use this formula, because this is A through non-diffusing B case. Na is equal to DAB PT by RTZ PBLN into PA1 minus PA2, where PBLN is equal to PV2 minus PV1 by ln PV2 by PV1. So in the next class we will discuss how this one looks like. Okay, if you have any doubts, just gather your doubts for the next class. Okay, the next class is the last class for the unit 1. So after that we will go for the unit 2 directly. Okay, I hope you understood this one. Thank you for listening. Bye.